Hey guys, Led here. So today we are at an investment property. A friend of mine who's an investor, he called me up, asked me to come over and look at this little house. The aluminum siding on it is, as you can see, is just, the color is gone. I'll get you some close-ups here in a second, but the color is gone. Looks to be in pretty good condition though. Doesn't look to be a lot of dents and things like that. So instead of replacing it, we're gonna paint it for him. He is going to replace all the windows. He had somebody come in and wash it down. So what we have to do now is put a good primer coat on it and a good finish coat on it. And so for primer, we're using a product called Gripper. It's a PPG product, and it does a really, really good job. You can literally put Gripper on glass, and once it dries, it's really hard to scratch off. So on this aluminum, it should bond extremely well. So we're going to get started priming this thing. We're going to spray applicate most of this. Some of it we're going to use a brush on. By this rock and stuff over here, I'm not going to try to mask that off. We'll just take a brush and cut to it, and then we'll take a sprayer and shield, and we'll finish it with a sprayer. But for the most part, we're going to spray it and see how she turns out. So stay tuned. All right, so Tim's using cardboard air on the front. A little faster than brushing that top piece. It looks better too, by far. So these little pieces of cardboard you can get at, I know Sherwin-Williams stocks them for us. We literally buy thousands of them a year. They actually have a little cutout handle. I can show you one here in a minute. And they really come in handy, not only for things like this, but even interior. We use them inside when we're shielding windows. Now remember, this is just a coat of primer we're putting on this. Tomorrow we're gonna start with finish on top of it. It's gonna look really nice once it's all done. Except for a few dings, it should look about brand new.
Yep.
All right, guys, so the pump we're using today is a Graco. It's called a Graco 495. It's an airless sprayer. This is one of the guns. This is the contractor gun. Airless pumps don't use air, they use a piston which forces the paint through the line. That's why you only have one line, one material line. instead of a conventional where you have an airline and a material line. So if your siding's in really bad shape, it's for like this, as you can see, the siding has almost no paint left to it. It's not that hard to fix. All you really need to do is wash it down really good. You can get some TSP from the paint store, from one of the hardware stores, or just a good detergent. Make sure you wipe it, scrub it really good, try to get all the chalkiness off of it, then get a high quality primer. An acrylic primer, this is called a gripper we're using. PPG carries it. It's a very good product. And when you're spraying with a sprayer, I'm gonna go ahead and run a piece of the siding for you. When you're spraying with a sprayer, you want your fan to be nice and equal, nice and even. So if after you spray you see fingers, like a line in your paint on the top and bottom, we call that fingering. That's because your paint's not properly mixed. Now a lot of painters will turn the pressure up to compensate for this, but the problem with that is you're wasting a lot of product. So you're better off throwing a mix to your paint. Like I put about in this five, I got about a half a gallon of water. All right, you big old bug, get out of here. In this five, I got about a half a gallon of water. We boxed it up and my pressure is about 1,400 pounds, so I'm not running a ton of pressure. It's a little higher than I like to use on the inside. I like to run even lower pressure on the inside for good control, but there's a little breeze today, so about 1,400 pounds, and it's giving me a gorgeous finish just like that. Now, bugs are gonna land in it, that's for sure. Let me do another couple swipes so you can see. It looks like new siding. Watch this guy's dog. This guy is hitting a baseball into his net. The dog thinks it's going down the road. Watch it. See that dog? That ball got caught in the net. The dog's still running. There he ain't no dog, ain't no ball here, puppy. Hey guys, if you're wondering why am I spraying the inside of the window here, simple fact is they're replacing these, and the bill or the investor asked me to just spray it just to kind of seal it up, so it'll be sealed even after they put the new windows in. That will be all sealed up, just to, you know, help keep from rotting or whatever. Alright guys, the house is primed. Now Tim is fixing to jump on this side right here and start using finish paint. On our ladders we have ladder mitts, and then on the ladder mitts we take clean rags and wrap them. That way a nice clean dry rag is going against that primer. We don't want to scratch or possibly pull any primer. I'm sure it's not fully cured yet, so we gotta be really, really careful. But when you put your hand on that gripper, you can tell that it's really on that metal. Sometimes you use primers, and when you touch, you can feel that it's not really on there. You can take your finger and just scratch it off. Well, this gripper, once it's fully cured out, you literally can't scratch it. So that's why we use it on this kind of job. Take you around the other side and show you Tim up on that peak. All right, guys, we have got it full two coats on the house now. A full coat of primer, full coat of finish. And the siding, the color, I mean, it looks brand new. Except for some dings that are in the siding. You know, because they're old. It's old. The side. And in the back there was a screened-in porch that was black. And we painted it white. Put a nice porch enamel on the floor porch back here, on the porch back here. So next is put the windows in. Once the windows are in, we're going to come back and do a little touch-up, most likely around the windows. I'll get you one final view of it. So guys, any comments or questions about how to paint aluminum, please put down below. If your house is all faded, it's not that hard to make it look brand new again. You just gotta use good products. And spraying it is really the best way to go because you get a super smooth finish. If you have to brush and roll, you can. But yeah, any comments, questions, please put down below. And if you haven't, subscribe if you could. Let out.